This is what the king Hezekiah experienced. He heard the voice of God. He clung to the word of God. The book of Wisdom, chapter 16, verse 12, we read, O Lord, any the medicines could not heal me. The herbs could not save me. But your word healed me, Lord. I hold on to your word of God. Hezekiah was holding on to the promises of the Lord. And he was going on repeating the promise of the Lord. Lord, you are this. You are a God of living. How can I die? You divide the Red Sea. You are mighty power of powerful God. Yes. When sickness comes, when fear and anxiety the enemy brings into your mind, you have to turn your worries into worship. And then all your challenges will become an experience of God. Turn all your worries into worship. Yes. And that's what Hezekiah did. And he received the healing. The second thing people don't get healed is because for them the fear they have becomes stronger and bigger than the faith. So what is strong in you? If the fear is ruling you, and the enemy will find its space in you. That's why in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 it is written, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but the spirit of love, courage, and confidence in the Lord. Hebrews 10:35, it is your confidence in the Lord. Let anything happen, your confidence in the Lord. My God, if God is for me, who can be against me? Yes, it is this confidence in the Lord will heal you. Enemy will bring fear, worries, anxieties. Oh, so many people died. So many people died. Few days ago, a priest from the US, Father David, the place where I went to preach the for the mission appeal, he called me and said, Father, 3 days we conducted the retreat, and the place where the word of God was proclaimed, and you know how people wept for their sin when you spoke about sin. And today in our town, all the other towns people are dying, but in our town, where especially around our church, we don't have even a single positive case. What a mighty God. What a mighty God to whom we belong to. He was so much excited and praising God. Yes, when you have confidence in the Lord, when you surrender to God, when you make your God your Lord, your faith in the Lord becomes stronger and the fear will go down. It is not easy to overcome the fear. You increase your faith. Don't fight against the darkness. Strengthen your light. Increase the power of your light. That's why in the book of Zechariah, chapter 9, verse 12, the prophet will say, oh, you are roaming around weakness. Get into your strength. Get into your fortress. And you will be safe. Maybe all kinds of fear, worries are surrounding you. Don't fight against your weakness. Get into your strength. And God will guide you. That's what we read in the book of Daniel chapter 6 verse 10. The Bible says, against Daniel, already even the law is passed by the king. He put his ring and put it, and nobody can change it. So what? As long as we have confidence in the Lord, we can overcome. Daniel went, opened the gates of his house, knelt down and started to pray to the Lord. And God protected him. God saw his confidence. He was not frightened. And God honored him. Yes. So you need to constantly, third, renew your mind. When you constantly renew your mind, you will experience the healing of the Lord. The enemy will attack the mind. The enemy will try to take away the strength from you. But you have to, if you want the healing of the divine mercy, you need to constantly renew your mind. It is not merely have mercy on me and on my family. Good, you pray. But have mercy on me and my family means what? Lord, we have made I and my family as you as our Lord and Savior. So, we have trusted in you. Jesus, we have trusted in you. So, you will take care of us. When tsunami came in Tamil Nadu, in Kanyakumari side, a particular family, they were on the seashore. They had a small hut. And they were living together. And in the morning, Sunday morning it was. So they came back from the church, husband and wife, and the two children. As usual, they were keeping the Bible, and they were closing their eyes, holding the hands, they were praying. They heard a heavy noise, sound, this and that. The children were shouting. The father said, "Close your eyes. Nothing will happen to us. Our God is great. Let me not change our time of prayer." And they started to pray. Continued to pray. And they forgot themselves. They were singing songs. And both the children were playing the instruments. And after 1 hour, when they opened their eyes and saw, though they were living, their place is a down place. All around there is water. Not only water, so many huts were destroyed, but the place they were kneeling and praying, around 1 furlong, absolutely nothing. Not a single drop of water. And they are in the like place like a pit. Nothing happened to them. When you walk in the presence of God, the Lord's divine mercy will take care of you. Fear will come. Satan will try to frighten you. But you have to renew your mind saying, nothing will happen to my God. Nothing will happen to me. Yes. My God will take care of me. The enemy will be fighting at our mind. And we have to renew our mind. That's what we read in the book of Daniel chapter 3. The king said, "I have made a statue and you have to worship it. If you don't do it, I will make the fire 7 times more than ordinary time and I will throw you into it." The world only can teach us, can show us to frighten us. But only God can make us the witness. The world can frighten us, but God will lift us. Where people are frightening us, there He will honor us. And these 3 men were thrown away. And their faith, God honored them. And the king saw, "Oh, we put only 3 people. Now 4 people are walking around. And the one who is guiding them is looking like a son of God with so much glory." When they came out, not a single hair of their head was having any smell of fire. Not a single hair was lost. Yes, the world will disturb us. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 10 verse 30, "Every hair of your head, your God has counted." The divine mercy is ready to heal you, provided very, very difficult situations will come in your life. You need to constantly renew your mind. When I was going through certain difficulties, as I was kneeling and praying, the Lord gave me a word in Jeremiah 31:10. Like the shepherd takes care of the flock, my God will take care of his own. But when I saw all adverse things, how is it possible? When I cling to that promise of the Lord, I saw every obstacle going away. And I am just lifted up. And I was saved. The world is world. It will try to do all kinds of tricks and evil. And it will frighten your mind. It will disturb your mind. But you need to constantly renew your mind. My God, my divine mercy, I trust in you. Oh, divine mercy, I trust in you.